According to the Ministry of Employment and Labor Relations, Ghana's unemployment rate stands at 13.44 as at March 2022, and that represents over 1.5 million people who are currently unemployed in Ghana now. And among these are the educated and the uneducated. This video is a story of a young lady who completed university and was a victim of the unemployment situation in Ghana for 3 years.
You graduated from KNUST in
2019.
So why didn't you do a job relating to your course?
2020, I did my self-service in my course. And then I came home. I applied to some of their firms. So during my stay at home, I didn't want to sit idle. And then also, as I said, there was through these applications that I was doing, I saw a project that was going around.
She didn't let the situation force her into any immoral act or into this so-called slave queen business in Ghana. The eagerness to start something herself got her into poultry farming.
This is my job. I love it. I don't regret going into poultry. I don't regret going into poultry.
Within a year, you are convinced this is your job.
No, this is my job.
Today, we are heading towards Ejoso, Sewa Akra in the Ashanti region, where this young university graduate tells her story of how she became a poultry farmer, the ups and downs, and the way forward. The motivation of this video is to encourage the youth out there not to give up, but rather start something with your hands. Don't forget to subscribe to this channel.
Okay, guys, we just reached our dear sister's house, and it's a very nice place. You just visit her and we know more about her. Yeah, that is our sister, Nila. Nila, it's been quite a long journey, but then finally we are here. Good morning, how are you?
Fine.
Let me, first of all, let me mic you so that our audience can hear you clearly.
Thank
is
you
okay?
Very much.
Picking it, good.
Yeah.
Okay, so Nila, we said we will visit and now we are here.
Yeah.
By the way, we are here to view one thing that our sister is doing, and then it's very encouraging, it's very educative, and I personally am challenged with it. So we'll get inside. She's an a graduate. She'll say everything herself. She's a graduate and she's now doing poultry. She started doing poultry very recently. What is your name? Full name, let our audience.
Okay. Please, I'm Nila Ejewa Bwedi. And the name of my farm is Nila Farms.
Oh, okay. Where is it located?
Please, it is located at Ejoso, Sewekra.
Sewekra?
Yes, please.
Oh, okay.
I have to pull my rubber sheets because of the cold weather. So I usually close it in the evening.
Oh, okay. But do they also feel the cold?
Sometimes.
With all the feathers?
Because they are small.
Oh, okay. Nice.
So
we'll enter, right?
Yeah. So please, before you enter, please dip your feet.
In the water?
Yes, please.
Why? What is the essence of it?
There are chemicals in it, a disinfectant, so that if you are coming from outside, maybe there is some
germs.
So I have to protect my beds, protect my farm. So the first thing, and it is also part of the biosecurity measures. So the first thing that you have to do is to dip your hand in my foot bath.
Okay, so make sure you guys also use the water there.
So please, these are my beds.
Okay. Wow. But then you said you were you went to the university.
Yes, please.
So why did you do animal farm? Did you do anything relating to
publishing studies?
Do they teach poultry stuff?
No. It's mostly designing, book design. Yeah. So
at KNUST?
Yes, please.
Which year?
2019. That was when I completed school.
2019?
Yes, please.
So why this?
Okay. First of all, I would say I had a desire for this when I was way young. And then also where I used to stay, my cousin that was staying with us started rearing turkeys. Mm-hmm. So after school, when I come home, I'll go to the miller, get food, bring it to them, feed them in the morning. It was a normal routine that I was doing.
For your cousin?
For my cousin.
Where was that?
I would say when I was in primary, primary going to GHS at Agric, that was where we used to stay. Mm. So I had the desire for birds from that stage. So after school, there was this project that was going around, Ghana Poultry Project, and I thank them very a lot because they have brought this into a reality.
Okay.
Someone would say, I want to start a farm. But it's all about capital. Where am I going to get the money from? So I applied. We went through trainings. We have to be interviewed. And then, first of all, they made us write a business proposal.
Wait. I want to understand something.
Okay.
You graduated from KNUST
2019.
So why didn't you do a job relating to your course? I just want to understand that area.
So 2020, I did my self-service in my course. And then I came home. I applied to some of the firms that I have to apply to, that I know that I have applied to. Yes. So during my stay at home, I didn't want to sit idle. And then also, as I said, there was through these applications that I was doing, I saw a project that was going around. That's why I said the Ghana Poultry Project. So they sent out flyers to youth. That was because I know it was around 20. Are you a graduate?
Okay.
Do you have the design poultry? So I decided to try my luck because after all, I had my desire when I was a child. So through that training that I had this.
So your main qualification, you tried and you couldn't get any job.
Yes, I tried and I couldn't get any job.
Wow. Yeah. Okay. But then I think this story is very common in this part because a lot of youth would, that is why we decided to come here.
Yeah.
Because looking at you, a university graduate and a lady, you could have gone in for anything.
Yeah.
You could have gone in to do a lot of things to get money. But then the inspiration is how you decided to enter. Because I know poultry, it smells. You should be honest. Their feces and other things. But then let's come back to you getting the forms from, you said it's which?
Ghana Poultry Project.
Okay, Ghana. Yeah. Is it a government or a private?
No, it is a private, and they had also the help in partnership with USAID.
Okay. Yeah. Okay, so let's say it's a private.
Yes, please.
So what did they do for you? How did they motivate you to start this thing?
Okay, so we went for meeting, for a three-day meeting, and after that, they told us to send our final proposal. We were over 50 people that went for that training. So they chose, out of the business proposal that we brought, we had 10, the top 10.
Mm-hmm.
So they were the people that qualified for the next stage.
Okay.
So we were able to, they took us through 3 months training, and the 10 people. So they took us through 3 months training in some of the farms.
To summarize, what was the package?
The package was to help us with the day old chicks, the equipment, that's the feeders, the drinkers, and just was to get a place to keep the birds.
A place and a structure.
A structure to keep the birds. That was your, but theirs was to cater for the vaccine, the day-old chicks, the feeders, the equipment, and the things that you would need, because it was a budget. So the things that you would need for that number. So I had 350 beds at my beginning. That was in December there.
December, that is
2021. Yes,
just this last year.
Yes, please.
So you are not even up to a year.
No, please.
Oh, wow. Wow.
Then I think, so you only do broilers here?
Yes, please. For now, it's just broilers. Mm. And then we are into a regular production. Yes. So my birds are always ready at 8 weeks. Yes. So when it's I start to advertise or start marketing my birds when they are at 5 weeks old, then I tell my customers about it. So after that, when they are 8 weeks old, I know that okay, I'll be sending some birds here and others. Yes.
This structure would cost.
Yeah,
graduates, lady with no job. How tough has it been? How is the struggle? Let's understand it.
Okay, it hasn't been easy. It hasn't been easy. I thank my family a lot, because if I didn't have this structure, getting that award
would have been useless.
Yes, please. So I thank my family a lot for the support and everything.
So they helped you.
They helped me with this structure, and I brought the bets in.
Wow. Well, that is great. Let's move around and get to understand some of these. You have several rooms here.
I have several rooms here.
So let's go through and see.
So with my pen, since I said it's a regular production, production, when the birds, I pick the birds when they are small, that's the day old chicks. Then I brood them myself. Yes. So I pick the birds when they are 4 weeks old. That's the interval that I have with them. So when they are 4 weeks old, I go in for another new set of beds. So these beds over here are four weeks old.
Are we free to enter?
Yes, since you step in the foot, but you are free to enter.
So this pen is for how many weeks?
Okay, these beds are 4 weeks old. Yeah, they are almost 4 weeks old. And this production 5. So I call them P5. That's the name that I've given
them. Let's the camera capture
so
all these things.
So as you can see, some of the birds are eating. So that's the feeders. So that's the feeders that they are eating from them. The drinkers also. So these are the birds. They are 400 in number, but they can't fit this size. Okay. So that's why I've divided them into two.
So these ones and these ones are the same.
They
class,
are the same
classmates.
Yeah, the same classmates. 196 over here.
Okay. Yeah. Nice. And then, do you have the next one too?
Next one to 7 weeks. So as you can see, they are almost ready for sales. They're almost ready.
7 weeks.
Yes.
Please. Like let's say less than 2 months.
Yes, please. So,
wow.
They're almost ready for sales.
Oh, fine. And you have their counterparts here.
You can even see they are really big. You can even weigh and see.
Wow. 7 weeks.
Yes, please. Seven weeks.
That's great. So with these ones too, how many do you have?
This 250. I normally take 200, and but I take an extra box in case of death or any other thing. So that's why it's 250.
Well, with my small this night, I learned these broilers, they are not that strong.
Yes, please. They are not that strong. But to me, I would say broilers are strong. Mm-hmm. It depends on how you do it. Mm-hmm. Yes, it depends on how you do it. Because if your vaccination, you make sure that your vaccination date, you adhere to it. Why should your broiler be sick or be soft? Yes, the meat is soft, as it says, since it is not kept for a very long time. That's why the meat is soft. But when you try and taste broiler chicken, you will get to know that it's really, really, really
so
nice.
Meaning that it is the nature for a broiler to be soft.
For
but
it
then
to be soft.
To be dying just like that,
no, it depends on you. Yeah, it depends on you.
Okay, so let me ask, what are some of the challenges now that you've started? What are the challenges you think poultry farm in Ghana or in general? What are some of the downsides?
Since I am in broiler production, I'll concentrate more on broiler production. The challenge that is going on right now is that mostly people say sales for broilers is just a seasonal something. But I sat down and said, oh yes, it is a seasonal something, but it can be an opportunity for me, because most farmers, after Christmas, Easter, then Salah, it's like, okay, let's pause and concentrate on our layers. Yes, but even if you would wear broiler, no one will come for it, and the price that they will give you wouldn't be very good. And broiler production too is very costly, because they eat. Yes. So one thing that I would say is a challenge now is with the importation of chickens from outside. That's very huge. So at the end of the day, even people are saying that Ghana economy is difficult and other stuff. If per my simple calculation, if I am an average person and I want to enjoy chicken, and I come to your farm and realize that maybe a chicken costs 60 Ghana cedis or 70 Ghana cedis, and I know that if I go to a cold store with the 60 Ghana cedis, I can get twice of that chicken. Definitely.
Which is not even fresh.
Yes, which is not even fresh. Definitely, I will just have to come stop yours and go and buy down, because I am looking at the monetary aspect.
So the importation of
broiler chicken, it's very, 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 very high, and then it is actually affecting us. But I don't use that one as a problem to me, because I try my best to do the marketing that I have to do, talk to people, because when you talk to some of them, they tend to tell you that, oh, broiler chicken, it's nice, I prefer the live one than the imported one. I've even lost the taste for that. Everything is the imported chicken. I have lost the taste for that. But this is a situation that they will come to your farm, because I have even gotten some people that order almost every time within a month. Is the chicken finished? I'll say no. Oh, then please bring me some. Is the chicken finished? I'll say no. Please bring me some. So these are the people that I have to look for them.
So you do the marketing yourself?
Yes, please. I did the marketing myself. Okay. For now, the business is a sole proprietorship business. So I do the
Go around.
I go around, search for people. Yes.
How do you do it? Because I should say, you are doing good for yourself, because I saw your small phone adverts on social media. In fact, a friend of mine who is also your friend shared it, and I saw it, and I was like, wow, this young girl, you are tiny. So I would say this tiny girl trying to do this.
it's actually viewers, it's not a big place.
It's not a big place.
But then for somebody, let's say a woman or a lady who has a degree to start something and try to do the marketing herself, go around, go to the market, go social media, advertise. I think that is how we got to know of her. And I should commend you for that. Uh-huh.
And then also, I want to also thank family and friends. Mm. Yes. The marketing isn't only, it's solely done by me. But when I also post on social media, they also
share.
So that they are also they have also helped me a lot. Mm.
Yeah. So you let's go through the other areas, and then we would wrap it up.
Okay.
So this also the other counterpart of
the 7 weeks.
Now I realize that
and then also they will say broilers, you can't get a manure for broiler.
Mm-hmm.
That was what like I knew, that with broilers their poo is very watery.
Mm-hmm.
So you can't get a dry manure for it. But as you can see, if the camera can just come where I am, or even from where you can see, it's not that wet. Mm. This is not wet. The manure isn't wet. It's dry. So I also sell the manure to the vegetable sellers.
Oh, okay.
And some people that come for the manure. Yeah. They break it perfectly for me.
So as you selling it means you change it?
Yes, please.
How often?
I make sure that I change it after the production.
The whole place?
No, where the beds are. So
okay.
These people, after I clear them out,
mm.
I remove the manure, everything, clean the whole room, everything, JJ.
For the fresh,
for the next production. Okay. Yes, for the next
so
production.
The next one will not come and meet
No. The next one will not come and meet any old manure here. I have to put a fresh wood shavings, as you can see from the other side. I'll put a fresh wood shavings, then it would go.
That is very nice. So I've seen that you also have some other birds here. We would try quickly see them, but then let's find a way to wrap this whole thing up. What is the future? Now you are a graduate. Are you doing this so that when you get a proper job you quit, or because you went to the university? I am more interested in that field.
Okay.
So what is the future? What is the vision?
This is my job. I love it. I don't regret going into poultry. I don't regret going into poultry.
Within a year, you are convinced this is your job.
No, this is my job.
Wow.
Yes.
Wow. That is great.
With a vision, I'm just hoping for a greater opportunity. I am just, because this is not where Nila Farms is going to be. No, no, not at all. With the bigger space that I am thinking of, it will get to a time with my capacity over here. It's just I can acquire, I can take 1,000 beds. If I want to do 1,000 production, that's what I can do, which is very, very, very small.
Yes.
Yes. So with my vision, I'm just looking into getting a bigger space, then doing the production big, because I am doing it all year round. It is a regular production. It will get to a time my clients wouldn't only rely on the imported chickens. We are actually talking with people who also who are into events, that also help people when they are doing their weddings and funeral. So at the end of the day, it wouldn't just be the imported chicken that you will just go to someone's program and go and enjoy. No.
Nila wants to change it.
Yes, Nila wants to
change
it. People are doing it. Yes, people
are
doing it. Yes, people are doing it.
So
let me understand. Because you want to do it a all year round production, it means that, let's say, if this one expands, meaning you would have to get people that will go around for supplies,
yes,
advertisements.
Yes, please.
It means that if Nila grows,
it's
about helping the whole community. Means,
that's the thing.
Because if it is all year round, it means that people will have to be doing the supply. Now it is small, so it's she small. Does it yeah. herself.
Yes, please.
But then if it is big, she would have to get a lot of people going round to deliver people's order and the rest.
Yeah, and then the farm work, everything.
Everything. Mm-hmm. Oh, I mean, really, really inspired. So, if you are watching us, wherever you are watching us, I think these are some of the stories that we should celebrate. These are some of the news that we should share and send around. These are some of the things. She could have decided to do a lot of things herself. She could have decided to just... People are saying you have to use what you have to get what you want. She doesn't believe in that. So she wants to do and start with the poultry farm. Okay, so do you manage or maintain the work, active work here? Do you do it alone?
Okay, I don't actually do it alone. My family helps out. Yes, my family.
When you say
helps
family,
out.
Who and who?
My father and a brother around that helps me out with it.
Your father?
Yes, please.
I think I have to see this your father because he gives you this space.
Yeah, he has really supported me.
And he's also working here as. But by the way, do you pay him?
Daddy, please, do I pay you?
Wow, I think we will meet him. We'll meet him because you said he started some birds here.
Yeah, he started.
And, what are those birds?
Turkeys.
Yeah. Oh, okay. Wow. Well, then since that has popped up, I think we have to check it. And then I think can we talk to Daddy?
Yes, please.
Okay. Okay. So we are about finishing the whole thing. We'll talk to Daddy, and then the message has been simple. The message has been very simple. Wow. So, Daddy started this one before?
Before me.
Oh, okay. That means you took the passion from the family?
Yeah.
the poultry rearing passion. You took it from the family. Okay, so we have the father of Nisila,
yeah.
A J, right?
A J-wa
here. And Daddy, once I've met you, but then thank you. You are really doing a very good
work. You're welcome.
We saw these turkeys, and she's saying it's for you.
Yeah, really.
Meaning that the inspiration to do poultry is from you, is from the family.
Well, me myself, I'm interested in farming.
Okay.
Honestly, I'm interested in farming. So maybe she's picking from it.
So when did you start this one?
Well, about 1.5 years ago. About 1.5 years ago. You know, I was about to leave. Let me give my background to you. I was an Northern Sector Auditor for SNET, from the Northern Region, Kumasi to the Northern Region.
Okay.
I was in charge in the North, the auditing side.
Okay.
And later they pushed me into the benefits. That's where we pay the benefits, those who are going on pension, DS, those who died. So I was in charge.
Mm-hmm.
So all this thing came to me and I was working on this. So, and I went on retirement. I retired somewhere around the... I'm now 11 years old now in my retirement.
11 years?
Yeah, 11 years old in my retirement.
If my calculations are good, you go on retirement 60.
Yeah.
Plus 11.
71. So I'm 71 years.
71?
Yes. And I have some small moms.
Congrats.
You are welcome.
And you are fixing your tie?
Yes.
Wow.
I'm doing it myself.
Well, then,
because I'm a sportsman. When I was in school, I was a sportsman.
We know where the energy from Nila comes from.
Okay.
71 fixing tie.
It's wow. True. So I decided
Now they took me, SNET took me on secondment to Abattoir, commercial abattoir. So I was the managing director for 11 years.
Okay.
And I decided that no, I'm getting old, so I must also get something doing in case I'm no more, my children also have something.
Sure.
So I started the, what do you call it, the turkey farming. I was having about 40 turkeys. I sold some, but some died. You know, the disease came into them and then I was losing them, especially when I was coming, picking myself to this place. You know, I was in the SNET bungalow.
Okay.
And I was leaving the bungalow to my own house. So automatically, the entrances, something might have happened. So I have this thing, I have the problem, but veterinary people helped me to maintain some of them. That's how, and I have only 12, but I've sold some and some have died.
I'm really impressed because these turkeys, it's very expensive and it's very tasty. So,
yeah.
So is the feeding of turkey different from?
No, almost the same, the same. The same. No different. So they are all best.
Well, that is great. That is great. In fact, thank you for sharing your experience with us. And I want to ask one last thing.
Okay.
Why is it that the Nila complete university? She said it's out of unemployment. How frustrating would it be for a parent when?
Well, you see, actually, when it becomes that point, then you don't know what to do. You become more frustrated. Not things that you're doing, but thinking of how to get your child to be involved in this thing.
Because you worry take one to school.
I was not getting to I was always on her. Have you written to these people? Have you written? Have you applied? Have you applied to SNET? Have you applied to this institution? Have you, all the time I was asking because I was very hurt.
Yes. So this structure,
yes,
you helped.
Yes,
that what is happened, why I wanted to talk to
what
you.
Happened was that when I was about to come, no, I left Kumasi Abattoir just this February because I told the board that where
just
I'm going,
February 2022.
Yes,
okay,
that I'm getting old and I have to do my own thing, so they should look for another managing director to come and take over for me. And lucky they had one. So this February, I said, no, I should start doing something. And then I said, I'm going to put a small cage for this pen animal, for the turkeys. Then he had already started going for the training and all these things. And then the people were complaining that before they can advance anything to them, they will come and see where they want to rear their animals or keep the animals at the best.
You can collect them and put them.
So I said, oh, if that's the case, yeah, then let me expand this one.
And give it to her.
And give it to her.
But then you could have expanded this one for the techie.
Yes.
But I decided to
give to her because she is beginning.
Yeah.
And I'm an old man.
Sure.
She will even come and look after me.
Yes.
So what again? So we had a fresh blood, so I should support her to do it.
Wow.
So I put this in for her. Formerly, I was having the whole side here for my techies and here for my techies. But I realized that it was not helping because she wants to do more.
She had the desire.
Yeah, she had the desire. And then I said, no, let me do some small thing for my techies. So I will move all the techies here and I'll give this into her so that at least they can pick up a 1,000 animals or can 1,000 beds. Yes. So they can pick 1,000 beds for this site. And then be working, especially this S-man's coming. So that's why I'm fighting to get this thing and then remove this one to come and add to them. So that I will be free and then she can do her work.
Thank you very much.
She's interested in the farming. She's interested in the farming. Farming and this is becoming an enclosed area. So you cannot be doing this thing all the time. We need to look for a land. And then when you look for a land, you must put up the structures
that
again.
One alone.
Yes.
One
so alone. It's roofing, a small thing.
From roofing.
So it's not certain. In fact, I was even asking her that, have you written to understand they have the youth what youth start or what do you call it?
Yes.
The youth start. So you should write to the youth start that at least he has interest in farming. He has even started at home. And see,
I know people will be watching this video and let's help. Let's help people who genuinely want to. Well, Daddy, we've spent some of your time. Thank you for supporting our lady.
Thank you too.
Thank you for being a very great dad. Because I think she's taking inspiration from you and continue to support her.
Thank you.
We thank you very much.
You're welcome. But I appreciate what you have done because from nowhere, you got to know us and then you have come to my house to come and teach us on all these issues.
Sure.
And I believe what you have done will take us far.
Sure.
May my God and self richly bless you all, and Amen. Let your work also grow.
Amen.
Gigantic, like all the other
people. Amen. Amen. God bless Amen. You all. So all these prayers for Jacqueline's TV, yeah. Our main motive is to promote our own,
yeah.
Promote Ghana in a positive way. The negative news is too much on the news.
Yes.
We don't want to rely on that. We don't want to lean on that. We want to rely on positivity, encouragement, and news that will uplift the youth. Okay, so Nila, your final words. We have explored your farms. Though it's not big as people would want to see a very big farm, but then we know that every big thing starts from something small. Yes, something small. So we have done our part. What do you have to say? What do you want to say finally to all loved ones or people who are watching us?
Okay, I want to say a big thank you to my potential customers and those that I am with right now. This is Nila Farms. We are in Tibuela production. We have dress beds, live beds, and grilled beds. So if you want your bed live, we will sell it to you. If you want it grilled, we will do it for you. And if you want it dressed, we will give that one to you. So just stay tuned for Nila Farms. And if you need any of our products, you can contact me on or WhatsApp me on 0203-894692.
Again.
0203-894692. Nila Farm, simply quality.
Okay, simply quality. Now we have her number. Those who are outside the country, those who want to help, those who want to come in a form of partnership. Maybe you have a land. I know a lot of people in abroad want to feel that they are helping in things that is realistic. That I should say realistic, because people are now scared of a lot of scams. We have met Nila. We have met the daddy. We have met the family all, and she is really passionate about this thing. If you have any means to help, you can just give her a call, talk to the family, strike out anything you want. If you want to just donate to her so that she can expand this one. She said this pen can take as much as 1,000.
1,000 bits.
How many do you have now?
For now is 450.
So it's not even up to half of this. Yeah. So you can help. If you also want to be serious and do business with her, just call her anywhere in Ghana. She would deliver it to you. Mm-hmm. Very neat. Yeah. And as I came here, I realized nothing stinks here. So she's keeping all the rules and regulations, all the personal hygiene that needs to be done. So this is Joseph Kofi Ejapon again. And once again, you are welcome. Or I'm signing off from Jacqueline's TV. We will meet you again, maybe in other places. As we said, our main motive is to expand, explore, and encourage things that are made in Ghana. Businesses that are made in Ghana. Things that will make us. And again, to help encourage the youth to start something with their hands. Thank you for watching, and catch you same time.
Bye.
We are out. Thank you.